So good morning. My name is G. Lakshmi Priyanka, Assistant Professor, St. Martha's Engineering College, Dolupalli. So today I am going to tell you about Laplace transform. So there are different types of mathematical tools available in our subject, that is like Fourier series, Fourier transform, Laplace transform and J transform. So today I would like to tell you about Laplace transform. So Laplace transform is like a foundation for Fourier transform. So from Fourier transform only you will get this Laplace transform. So even though if you are having Fourier transform, why we are going for Laplace transform is the first question it will arise for the student. So Fourier transform, with that you can solve all the periodic and aperiodic signals. But this Fourier transform only involves the real parts of the signal. While coming to the Laplace transform, it could solve both real part and imaginary part, which is nothing but you can, if you observe a Laplace transform, so it will be generally represented with the equation like S is equal to sigma plus j omega. Here sigma indicates the real part and j omega indicates imaginary part. So that's why this S variable, whatever S I am taking, this variable is representing Laplace transform. This S variable is called as complex variable. So the another name of this S is complex variable. Why I am calling this as complex variable? Because it is a combination of real and imaginary. Means whatever signal you are giving, that signal, if it is consisting both real and imaginary parts, you can solve it with the help of the Laplace transform. So Laplace transform, already I told you, same like Fourier transform and Fourier series J transform, it is also one mathematical tool. And coming to the Laplace transform and Fourier transform relation. So if you are taking a Laplace transform equation, so capital X of S is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity X of t e power minus st dt. So I have taken, first only I have taken the equation of Laplace transform. Now what I am going to do means I am going to substitute this S is equal to sigma plus j omega is there, no? So I am substituting this equation 1 in equation 2. So where is this? Here it is there. So here x of t e power minus sigma plus j omega t d. So what I did in the place of S, I have substituted sigma plus j omega. Now I am considering, so let us consider that sigma equal to, sorry, before considering sigma equal to 0, what we have to do, so here it is in the format of e power a plus b. So whenever you come across the equation like e power a plus b, what you have to do? So first you have to split it. So how you will split it? Integral minus infinity to infinity, you will write x of t same as it is, e power a into e power b, you will split as e power a, you can write it as e power a plus b. Now e power a plus b is there. Now I will write it as e power a into e power b. Like that I have written. Now what I am doing? I am considering sigma equal to 0. So when sigma equal to 0, what happened? What happened? X of t will remain same as it is. E power, in the place of sigma, I am substituting 0, so it will become 0. And e power minus j omega t will remain same. Now e power 0 means already everyone know e power 0 answer is 1. So in the place of e power 0, what we have to do? So we have to substitute x of t e power 0 1 into e power minus j omega t d. Then what happens? At last we got the equation, integral minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt, which is nothing but capital X of omega, which is nothing but capital X of omega. So here capital X of omega means what? This is representing Fourier transform. So from Fourier, sorry, Laplace transform equation, I have derived which equation? Fourier transform equation. So this topic is nothing but relation between Fourier transform and Laplace transform. So Fourier transform means what? You will convert a continuous time domain signal into a frequency domain signal. Okay, time domain signal into frequency domain signal. Here also we will do the same, but here we will process both on real and imaginary parts. So this is the introduction of Laplace transform, how we got the relation between Fourier and Laplace. So vice versa also students can do. From Fourier they can derive this one. Okay, so now I will explain the important as transform. So generally, you know, in this all of you know, once observe this equation, this is the question given in the exam. So they may ask you that calculate the Laplace transform for the given equation. So if this is the equation x of t is equal to e power plus cat into u of plus t is the question given for you. Now what we have to do, first we have to write the equation. What is the equation? We know Laplace transform equation, integral minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus st dt. Like that I have written the equation. Now what we will do here, first of all we have to consider the function. Function we will substitute here. Then what happens? Like this, the equation will be written, that is e power plus a t into u of t into e power minus st dt. Up to here it is okay. Now here you have to observe this u of t. U of t is what? It is an unit step function. So u of t is 1 for t greater than 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. So this is the functional representation. So any signal will have functional representation, graphical representation. So this is functional representation. What is graphical representation? So here see, we are taking a continuous time signal, that is unit step function. So I have written here u of t, and here if you observe, its amplitude is 1. So starting from 0, it is infinity. So u of plus t, the limits will start from 0, will end at infinity. So now here u of t is given. So now what? How we have to process means simple. Here u of t function is what? 1. So I have to replace this u of t with 1. Same, at the same time you must also change the limits. What are the limits for unit step function? Starting is 0. That means this is the lower limit. And infinity is the upper limit. UL I am writing. Lower limit LL, upper limit UL. Means this limits will change like 0 to infinity. So that one I will write here. Okay. See. This one. X of t is, capital X of s is equal to, what I told you, first you have to change the limits. So u of t limits are 0 to infinity. E power a t remains the same. U of t, what is the amplitude? 1. So I have to write the 1 here. Then e power minus s is there. I will write the same thing. And dt. Like that I will write. Now after writing this, so once observe this, e power a t into 1, anyways it is e power a t. E power a t into e power minus s t is there. Means same formula, right? E power a into e power b, you will get e power a plus b. Now how we will write this one? X of s is equal to 0 to infinity e power a minus s t b. Like that you will write. Or otherwise, in another way, how you will write? If you take minus common, minus if you are taking common, what happens? A plus s t. Why I am writing like this? Because I am taking minus common. Okay, sorry. S minus a. Okay, so now what we have to do? Now we have to integrate, simple integration. So e power anything, it will be same, only the denominator, the part which is x right is there, you will get. Now after integration, what you will do? Simply you will substitute the limits. So first of all, anytime while substituting the limits, first you have to substitute the upper limit minus 0. Okay, so by substituting, what the answer you will get means, so first you will substitute e power infinity by s minus a minus e power 0 minus s minus a. So what is the answer you will get? Now e power infinity, what will be there? 0. E power 0, answer will be 1. Here minus is there, minus minus gets cancelled. So what will be the answer? 1 by x minus a is the answer for this equation. That is the question given, e power plus a t into u of t. The output you obtained is 1 by s minus a. So if you wanted to get the poles and zeros in order to draw the graph, that is for Laplace transform, that means for s plane, you will call that graph as s plane. Then you have to consider this denominator. Denominator, if you are making it equal to 0, then you will get pole. Here pole I will get as s equal. So this is the pole. With this you can draw the graph. Suppose if I wanted to graph for this, draw the graph for this one, I will draw the graph. On x axis I will plot sigma and y axis g omega. This is x plane. Okay, so here I draw the dotted lines I have represented, no? So here u of plus t is there. Means what you have to consider, you have to draw the lines, horizontal lines. So this is u of plus t means it will be greater than u. Okay, means the ROC will be S greater than A. ROC means region of convergence. Okay, so region of convergence means what? So whenever you are taking S, so S means, S is representing the complex variable, that is nothing but Laplace transform, representing term is S. So when in whatever area it is there, when you are able to represent S, wherever the S is converges, that area is called region of convergence. So here after making denominator equal to 0, you got A. So I have plotted this plus A, I have plotted on the right side. If you got minus A, you have to plot it on the left side. So after plotting it, what you have to observe, you have to decide whether you have to draw the horizontal lines greater than A or less than A. So that decision you can take with the help of u of plus t. Suppose here u of minus t is there, what you will do? The same graph will be there, same A will be there, same plus A, but you will draw towards the left side. So on x axis, as usual, you will take sigma, on y axis, you will take j omega, and you will call this plot as S plane. The ROC is starting from here and going this side. When? So when you are having the equation like u of minus t. Okay, so like this, you will get the plot. Okay, here the answer will vary, but how to draw the graph I am telling you. Depending upon u of plus t and u of minus t, it will range. Okay, so anyways, for any transfer function, you know that the numerator, if you are making it equal to 0, it is called 0. And if you are making denominator equation equal to 0, it is called pole. So here you have to consider the denominator equation, make it equal to 0. According to that, you have to get the answer. So different types of equations will be there. So especially our Laplace transform is of two types: unilateral Laplace transform, bilateral Laplace transform. So first equation I wrote here, this is indicating the bilateral Laplace transform. Why? Because it is starting, the limit is starting from minus infinity and it is going up to plus infinity. But here if you observe, here I wrote only according to the u of plus t, I wrote from 0 to infinity. So whenever you are writing minus infinity to infinity, it is bilateral Laplace transform. Otherwise, if you are writing 0 to infinity or minus infinity to 0, like this, if you are writing like this, these two indicates unilateral Laplace transform. So Laplace transforms, bilateral and unilateral, these two types are also very important. So while after telling the problem, I thought that I would tell you. Okay, so this bilateral Laplace transform means it would include both left side and right side, right handed side of the S plane. Okay, here why it is named as unilateral means it will include either right side or left side of the plane. Only one side of the plane will be included. That's why it is called unilateral. See here, both left side, that is from minus infinity to 0 and 0 to infinity, both sides of the planes are included. That's why it is called bilateral Laplace transform. You can also call it as two-sided Laplace transform. Okay, this unilateral can also be called as one-sided Laplace transform. So these are the important points regarding the Laplace transform which I have covered in this video. So once in a glance I will tell you, so what is the Laplace transform? So by using this Laplace transform mathematical tool, you can convert a time domain signal into frequency domain. Especially you can process the complex variables. Then how many types of Laplace transforms are there? Two: unilateral, bilateral, and their indication limits I have told you. Then I have told the relation between Fourier and Laplace transform. So by making sigma 0, you can get the Fourier transform equation. That is the relation between Fourier and Laplace transform. Then I have explained the important problem. So this problem is repeating in previous year questions, question papers. So e power 80 into u of t. So by taking the main equation, I have told you how to substitute. Here the key part of the problem solving lies here, whether it is u of plus t or u of minus t. According to this, you have to solve, you have to integrate, substitute. After getting the answer, you have to make denominator 0 and according to that you have to plot the ROC that is on the S-plane. So thank you.